Hey, I got a story to tell you. A story that's not hard to tell. I don't think it ever was. I'm not gonna try and hook you with anything to get you to watch this, but, well, because I know this is gonna go around the world. Something that's intense. Because, some of us, God destines to walk through fire. So, that being said, I live in Kansas City, Missouri. That's why I'm a little sweaty, humid out here, and hot, as always, every summer. So I'm sorry I look gross. I have four kids, 15, 6, 3, and 3 months and 26 days, or about 7, 8 months. I'm not sure how to say it, but that's where the story goes. It's about my youngest girl. Her name is Saphree Johnson. She was born January 11th. she had a few conditions of the heart, and we knew it. Nobody told us anything that would be highly problematic. Nobody pointed us in that direction. Maybe a little bit of a problem throughout our life, but you know, hearts can be tricky. So, about 3:30 a.m., May 7th, my wife called me in the kitchen. She was highly distressed. She showed me our baby. Her lips were blue and struggling to breathe. And I knew right away something was wrong. So I called the police. They came out and actually took over from my wife, doing CPR. Is that serious? And EMT showed up not long after that. They load her on the truck, and I got my van to follow them, and I knew within probably 15 seconds, one but a few turns in this neighborhood, that I knew I was gonna lose a baby that day. So I prayed to the Lord, and I told him, God, prepare my heart. And so we get to the hospital about 15, 20 minutes later, seemed like forever. and I get in the room, and there's, I would say, about 12 or 14 people all doing their task to help her. And after a little over an hour, I knew their efforts weren't going to amount to success. And I still commend them. They gave it all they had. I just knew this was out of their hands. in the moment that Saphree was, she was taking these deep breaths, and the, head doctor came behind me and told me what she was doing, and I forget the term, but basically when you're dying, your body naturally expels all the oxygen, out of your body. It just does that naturally. And in that moment, with all the chaos and the hurt, the confusion, everything going on inside of me, and my emotions and my mind, the question blaring loudest was, God, why? Why? Why would you let this happen? I live for you. I live for Jesus. I don't understand. But all that came out was God, why? I've asked a lot of questions in 33 years of life, and none with an immediate audible answer. But that time he showed up, and he answered me in a way that was so warm and inviting, familiar, very comforting and reassuring, kind of like the way a hero reassures and just makes the person in need put all of themselves into that hero saving them. It was like that, but to a higher degree. Just the way that he expressed it to me in that tone, I trusted him immediately. And what he told me was, Just trust me. Trust me. For all you parents out there, you know that's... I'm like, what? My mind couldn't keep up with that at the time, you know. I had a lot going on in my head, and I was calm the entire time. I wasn't angry. I wasn't upset. I was just sad and confused. But when he told me that, that was accompanied by a wave. It was like a blanket that came over me and into my heart of peace, of joy and happiness, of strength, power. A lot of things that were all good and I knew it was from God. And when he told me that, I just responded with, okay. I try to live my life according to 1 Thessalonians 5, 16, 17, 18, which reads in my Bible translation, rejoice always, pray continually, and in all circumstances, give thanks to God. Because this is the will for our lives. That he has for our lives. In that circumstance. In this circumstance at the time. Rejoice. Pray. And thank God. And I did. It was hard, but I did. Because no matter what, one thing I know about that verse is that tells me God comes first, always. It's God, the Trinity, Jesus, Holy Spirit. God first, and then your family, or your spouse, and then your kids, however you want to say that, and then work, and however you want to prioritize your life, but it's God first, always. It's number one. And I defaulted to that in that moment. Not to my own credit. That was the strength of God that really held me and stood me up. So I told him okay, and he just overwhelmed me and overcame all of the hurt and pain and everything bad in that situation. It was hard, but the good was more powerful by a lot. And from that point to this point, I never got angry. I'm not being driven to alcohol or drugs. I'm not going to split up with my wife. I'm not tossing my kids around or punching holes in my house. None of that. I was sad. We mourned, and we still do. This is very much an open wound still. But it's like God took us by the hand. He's taken us by the hand, and he's walking with us through this storm. So there's that. Trust God, whether you understand it or not. And I don't. I very lightly have a tiny grasp of this in my mind, but it's really just my spirit, my mind, or my heart that says, yes, God, okay. I don't get it, but I'll trust you. I will live for you, and I will dedicate all of me to your cause. That's where I'm at. And shortly after that word from Lord, we actually kind of had a slight dialogue, and I said some more things to him and kind of went between mourning and just trying to understand this. And he shortly after came back and told me, kind of shifted gears, changed the tune, and said, don't tell the world she died. Tell the world Jesus lives. That kind of caught me off guard, but I will do so until I'm dead, because I think there's an emphasis on that, that she's okay. My girl's okay. I could trust him with her. I'm more confident that she's in heaven, a place no safer and nowhere that's more fun and awesome, and in the hands of someone that you could trust more than any other being in the universe. And then to go from that, he kind of pushed me forward and said, it's already time to move on. That's kind of the feeling I got. And when he gave me this great peace and joy and happiness, I have very little sorrow. And I don't know, it's still there. But God is overcoming it, and I'm able to tell everybody that comes in my path the story. The love of God that is pure, and it's for everybody. No matter where you are, if you are a parent that's lost a kid, whether it be a miscarriage, abortion, stillborn, or one like mine that just didn't make it because of a natural cause or whatever the situation is, Jesus loves the children. Like he said in the word to his disciples, he rebuked them and said, no, don't push them away. Don't keep the kids from me. Let them come. For the kingdom of heaven belongs to such as these, to kids. And I think we'll be surprised and amazed just how many kids there are in heaven when we get there. For those of you that belong to Jesus and have that salvation. Or maybe they'll be grown up by the time we get there. I don't know. I only know a little bit. But first I trusted God, not knowing, and then the knowledge came and I started to learn some things. He showed me things over time. And the next morning, my wife, I woke up to her crying because we co-sleep with our kids because, it's a bad idea, but the kids love it, so we just do it for usually about the first year of their lives. My wife thought Saphree was in the bed for a split second, and she wasn't. So I naturally rolled over to hold her, and as I rolled over, God gave me a gift. He gave me a vision of the truth. And I saw a white room. I can see it very clearly in my mind right now. It was a white room, about a medium size, like a large, like a master bedroom in most homes. And I saw him. I saw Jesus holding my girl. He was holding her, over his left shoulder the same way I did. My house, walking through the hallways, putting her to sleep, and just holding her. And she was wearing a bright yellow. It's like a nightie, like a little baby pajama sack, but this one was sleeveless. But I saw her backside, and I saw Jesus' front side with those eyes just like white beams of fire. I can't really explain it, but I recognized her black hair with those little spirals in the back. He showed me the truth. He took her. And it's because of that truth and other truths that I've discovered and have been shown to me. And told to me by friends. It's because of the truth, ultimately, the big picture, that I'm okay. Yesterday marked a 3-month anniversary that she's been gone from us. And I'm very much at peace and still have that same joy and peace and happiness and strength that is imparted to me by the hands of God. I can't even explain the power of it, but it is very real, and the only reason that I'm okay, better than okay, I'm fantastic. Look at my face. This is the face of a happy father. Face of a father that knows the truth, that has a firm grasp of some of that truth and of the truth that I've been shown, told. It is a face of a father that has four kids. Yeah. I'm more confident of that, that she's there, than the sun is going to rise tomorrow morning. Or that the earth revolves, however you want to say that. So that's it. That's the message. Jesus is alive. Trust God. Jesus came to save you. And he is the way, the truth, and the life. And nobody goes to the Father. Nobody goes to heaven except through him. So give yourself to him. Especially if you're a parent. God loves your kids far more than you do. And he has them. All of them. No matter their background or who their parents are. If their parents hate God. don't believe in God. That doesn't affect the kids. God takes them. That's ultimate mercy and love and grace. And they become residents of heaven. I could tell you an awful lot of stories, but that's this story. So you parents out there should be addicted to God as I am, and love him and be so much more grateful. Your prayers and your minds, all my prayers are just in pure gratitude. I thank him every day. I love him, and I'm crazy about God, about Jesus, because I have the truth. I know it. So tell a friend, look up my girl Saphree Johnson, Saphree. Look at her face, a happy little baby. And know the truth that I'm telling you. And know that she's alive, along with an awful lot of other babies. Other stories out there coincide with this. And there's a lot of truth of these stories. So, I love you guys. Go find Jesus. Talk to him.